There are two ways to estimate the total number of squares that are installed on the roof. One way includes measuring the area of the house footprint and multiply that by a roof slope factor. Another way includes measuring the area of each plane on the roof and add them all together. In this video, we're going to learn how to measure each plane of the roof to calculate the total square footage. To do this, you have to measure the length and width of each plane on the roof, including the dormers. Then multiply length by width to get the square footage of each plane. Finally, calculate the roof's total square footage by simply adding the square footage of each of the planes together. There are several different styles of roofs, including shed roofs, hip roofs, and gable roofs. This is a shed roof. A shed roof has one roof plane. Simply measure the length of A, then measure the length of B. Now the area of the shed roof is A times B, which is, in this example, 12 and a half feet times 12 and a half feet, which is 156 and a quarter square foot for the total square footage of the shed roof. This is a square. The area of a square is simply base times height. In this example, the base is 12 and a half and the height is 12 and a half. This is a rectangle. The area of a rectangle is just like a square. It is base times height. And in this example, the base is 15 feet and the height is 12 and a half. The area of the rectangle is therefore 15 times 12 and a half, which equals 187 and a half square feet. This is a gable roof. A gable roof has two planes. So multiply the base times the height for each plane or rectangle to get the square footage for each plane. Then add the two rectangles together to get the total square footage of the roof. So let's assume one rectangular plane of the roof is 16 by 40 and the other plane is 16 by 40. The area of each plane is 16 times 40 equals 640 square feet. By adding the two rectangular planes together, the total square footage of the roof is 1,280 square feet. This is a hip roof. Now a hip roof has four planes, and they are not rectangular like the other roofs, so you'll need to know some simple geometric formulas to calculate areas of roof shapes, including trapezoids and triangles. A hip roof will include a trapezoid shape. To calculate the area of a trapezoid, you add the length of each base, base 1 plus base 2, and then multiply it by height. Then you divide that by 2 to get the square footage of the one trapezoid plane. In this example, one of the hip roof's trapezoid planes is 10 plus 15 times 12 equals 300 divided by 2 equals 150. Remember, that's just for one of the trapezoid shapes of the hip roof. In this example, there are two trapezoid shapes. In the illustration, you can see this hip roof has two trapezoid shapes and two triangle shapes. So let's look at calculating the area of a triangle. The area of a triangle, regardless of the triangle shape, is base times height times 1/2. In this example, the area of the triangle is 8 feet times 10 feet times 1/2 equals 40 square feet. The four planes of a hip roof include two triangles and two trapezoids. Calculate the area of each shape and add them all together to get the total square footage of the hip roof area. Here are several different types of roofs and their area calculations. Let's take a complex house roof as an example and calculate its total square footage. This complex roof has lengths of various geometric shapes of the roof measured. The main house roof is a large gable roof. Looks like the front entry has a small gable roof. The rear deck has a hip roof there. And there's a gazebo roof attached to the back of the house. Let's calculate the area of this complex roof in total square footage. Let's start with the red octagon, A4, which is just like a bunch of triangles stuck together. We know that the area of a triangle is base times height times 1/2. So the octagon is 8 of those triangles added together. So if the base is 5 feet and the height is 6, the area of the octagon is 8 times base times height times 1/2, and it equals 120 square feet. Now let's look at the yellow shapes. The area of the east gable, A3, is the addition of 2 trapezoids. We know that the area of a trapezoid is base 1 plus base 2 times height times 1/2. So for this house, the east gable, A3, is 16 feet 3 inches plus 10 times 5, which is height, times 1/2. But because there are 2 trapezoids, you double that amount to get the total square footage of the east gable roof in yellow. The west gable roof is measured by calculating the area of one of the trapezoids and then doubling it to get the total square footage. It's the same method we used for the east gable roof. Next is the big blue section, a gable roof with 2 large rectangular planes. We know that the area of a rectangle is base times height. For this house roof, we have base times height as 10 times 60, or 600 square feet. Because there are 2 rectangular planes, the total square footage of the blue main house roof, A1, is double that, 1,200 square feet. Due to the overlap in areas, we must subtract a portion of each yellow gable from the main house roof total. So, the green dashed lines indicate the areas that must be subtracted from the main house roof, A1. Here's the breakdown of all the shapes and their areas. When you add up all the shapes, the total roof area is 1,820 square feet. Now convert the total square footage to roofing squares. In roofing terminology, a square is 100 square feet. Now divide the total area by 100. So 1,820 square feet, that's the total area of the entire house roof, divided by 100 equals 18.2 squares. This answer is the number of roofing squares for the roof, 18.2. So in summary, we learned how to calculate the size of a roof by measuring the total square footage of the roof and dividing that by 100. Remember, the area of a square is simply base times height. The area of a rectangle is just like a square, base times height. The area of a triangle is base times height times 1/2. The area of a trapezoid is base 1 plus base 2 times the height times 1/2. And a square, in roofing terms, is 100 square feet.